When you think about astronomy, virtually everything you've ever heard, everything you know, is astronomy that's been learned with a telescope. All of us have grown up in a world that sees the universe through the eyes of Hubble. But there's a lot about the stories that you can't just learn from the light. And the thing that's so exciting about this event is that it's something we've always known, we've always predicted, that if you had light and gravity together, the two pieces of information could tell you something more.
LIGO had its first gravitational wave detection 2 years ago. And that was, of course, the beginning of a new field, the field of gravitational wave astronomy.
LIGO's detections before have all been of black holes. And so we've been waiting for this event.
The news of this detection first came out on the morning of August 17th. First, there were several emails sent around to members of the LIGO and Virgo scientific collaboration saying that an interesting alert had been picked up that may or may not have been a gravitational wave source.
The signal was so loud. Internally, we knew there was nothing it could be besides what we thought we were sending the alert for.
So we had the gravitational wave signal, and then within a couple minutes, we got another alert that came in from one of the satellites that had recorded a signal in gamma rays, which are very high energy light, about 2 seconds after the signal.
That moment was the moment that I realized that maybe this is actually the source that we've been all waiting for.
What we were seeing in the signal was the spiral dance and eventual death of a pair of neutron stars.
A neutron star is a collapsed skeleton of a star. When the star explodes and dies, it compresses down to something about the size of a city. And the whole star, more or less, is composed of ultra-dense neutrons. It's like a giant atomic nucleus the size of a city.
And these two neutron stars spiraled in towards each other and actually collided. And what we detected is we detected how these neutron stars actually rippled the fabric of space itself.
It's just like having two cars that they crash. So this very same thing also produces light. And this jet is a source of radiation across the spectrum. So you go from gamma rays all the way to radio. So gamma rays, X-rays, UV, optical, infrared, millimeter, and radio, everything.
Because we have this EM follow-up, we have a picture of the galaxy that it came from. You can see the little kilonova. You can see how far from the center of the galaxy that it is. And based off of what we know about these type of galaxies, you can kind of make a model of this galaxy.
And that's the amazing thing with this source. For the first time, we saw the final collision of two neutron stars. And for the first time, we saw this multi-messenger message of combined gravitational waves and electromagnetic waves.
So right now, the thing that we're worried about is, well, what did they become? What happens to two neutron stars when they combine? Do they make one new gigantic super neutron star? Or do they become a black hole? We don't know.
So this is the beginning of a very exciting time. And this event that we saw actually highlights also the importance of making it better.
But that's why we do astronomy. We keep looking because we're going to pile more and more onto the pile of things that we've seen, and it will eventually illuminate that question.
This is, of course, an amazing feeling to have solved one long-standing mystery, to have opened up a new field of multi-messenger astronomy. One might say, you're done. Okay, let's go home. But in reality, this is just the beginning for us.
Just like when people were first building telescopes and looking up and there was amazing things to see that surprised them, we are now in an era where we have a new sort of telescope and we can look at an entirely new channel of information.
It's one of the most monumental feats in modern astrophysics. And decades from now, maybe even centuries from now, people will look back at this event and say, this is where it started.
It's an exciting time to be involved with this because we're just seeing the tip of the iceberg of what might be possible.
Who knows what awaits us as we discover more of these neutron star mergers.